Today I'm going to show you how to use a vSystems web wallet. So first we open the website, and you can find a link from the official website to the mainnet hot wallet right here, as you can see. However, this is just a demo video, so I'm going to use a testnet wallet to show you how the transactions work. So testnet website is test.v.systems, as you can see. And this is our first time using a wallet, so we need to create a new account. So we input our chosen username, as so, and we can select the number of addresses that we want for our wallet, and I'll just put 5 here. Now we enter our chosen password, like so, and we click register. Now you see 15 words in front of you. This is the seed. And you need to make sure you back up or write down these 15 words and make sure you have these 15 words recorded somewhere. So now we click continue to confirm. And if we've backed up the seed in the correct way, clicking these words in the right order should be a simple task. So what is the seed phrase and why is it so important? A seed phrase is a list of words which stores all the information needed to recover a vWallet. So if you ever lose your account, as long as you know the seed, you can always recover your account using the seed. All account addresses are generated by seed. And now we'll just quickly click these 15 words. As you can see, we've created a new wallet with 5 different addresses. Now I'm going to demonstrate how to do a payment transaction. First, you need to know the address of the recipient, so I'm just going to copy it here. And now we have the address of the recipient. Now we need an address that has some coins, and we can send. We paste the recipient's address in here, and let's send 1 VSYS here. Click continue and click confirm. And we should see that the balance has updated and has been correctly recorded in transaction. And we can look at the other wallet to see. Yep, and the balance has correctly updated and has been correctly recorded in the transaction records. We previously demonstrated the payment transaction in the hot wallet. So the hot wallet refers to the real-time network wallet, which allows easy and quick transactions. Now we introduce the cold wallet. Cold wallets are designed for maintaining the complete safety of Vcoins. Note that although I say Vcoins, the coin symbol is actually VSYS. The cold wallet is disconnected from the network at all times and only comes online when the valid signature is presented. We suggest users who own a large amount of Vcoins to use the cold wallet to store their coins, as they ensure a high level of security. As the cold wallet is disconnected from the network at all times, it's slightly more difficult to check the balance and transaction. So for this, we use our hot wallet to monitor the cold wallet. First, we click monitor cold wallet here. Then we open our cold wallet in the mobile device and show the cold wallet address. So now we successfully accessed the cold wallet. Now we can see the balance and the transaction history on this page. Now I'll show you how to transfer coins out from the cold wallet. It's more or less like transferring in the hot wallet. We click send. We need to first copy an address. So I'm going to send it to this account. So now we paste the recipient address here. and we'll send one Vcoin out. Then we click continue and confirm. Now, a QR code will pop up. This QR code contains transaction information for the Cold Wallet signature. We open the Cold Wallet and scan the QR code. Then the Cold Wallet will also show a QR code. This is the Cold Wallet signature for this transaction. We click continue and scan the QR code of the Cold Wallet signature. Like so. And we click confirm. And we should see that we successfully transferred one Vcoin out of the Cold Wallet to this wallet address here. As you can see, the transaction was successful. Unlike a centralized server or system, all wallet data and information are only stored offline and not online. This means that for the web wallet, it is only stored in the local browser. Once you change browsers or clear caches, the account will disappear. To recover our wallet account, we need to remember the seed and restore the account from the seed. Now I'll show you how to restore the account. First, we clear the cache. And if we refresh the page, we should see that the wallet is now gone. So how do we restore the account? We click Restore Account from Backup and enter the seed phrase that we recorded from before. Like so. Click Continue, and once again we can enter our chosen username and restore the number of addresses that we wanted and type in our chosen password. Click Update Your Account, and we should see that we've recovered our account. So that's it for the hot and cold wallet operations. Thanks a lot for watching, and I hope you enjoy using the web wallet for vSystems.